Hey nerds, wanted to start today's video with a short clip with a caption from Alex over on X. Tesla showcased its 4 exaflops Dojo supercomputer with Tesla Transport Protocol over Ethernet at the Hot Chips 2024 conference. Car companies sure are very high tech these days. So hang on a second. A quote, car company appearing at a Hot Chips conference? It's kind of weird. Why would just a car company have anything to do with chips, let alone be presenting some of their hardware at a chips conference? It's kind of strange. Does anyone have any ideas why Tesla would be presenting at the Hot Chips 2024 conference? Oh, look, I'm sure it's nothing. Wait, what's this? From Elon Musk. Video of the inside of Cortex today. The giant new AI training supercluster being built at Tesla headquarters in Austin to solve real-world AI. Now, I'm not a very smart person, that's why I just make videos on the internet, but can somebody explain to me why just a car company would have a gigantic AI training supercluster, and why would they have called it Cortex, which is like, that's sort of suggesting a brain. Like, that's a weird thing to do when you're just a car company competing in the automotive industry, trying to sell vehicles to consumers, competing against companies like the Chinese electric vehicle makers who are going to steal your market share, allegedly. Weird, I'm sure it's nothing. And while we're on the subject of actual car companies, Honda US executives say they can't force people into electric vehicles. Quote, you can't force the customer to change their mind, says Honda's US CEO on the sidelines of the Monterey Car Week. Honda has pledged to invest $64 billion to develop 7 bespoke electric vehicles, which it plans to launch by 2030 on its way to selling only electric vehicles and full cell vehicles after 2040. Yeah, you heard that right. These dumb fucks still think in 2039 they're going to be selling internal combustion engine vehicles. However, there doesn't seem to be a consensus within the company that there is enough demand for EVs, which is reflected in its limited selection of available battery-powered models. Now, the reason we're jumping back and forth, Tesla, AI, supercluster, Dojo flexing at a chips conference, and then back to dumb fuck legacy automotive companies who are telling everybody about their plans to invest $64 billion developing electric vehicles by 2030. It's just to make sure people understand. Tesla has been all in on electric vehicles since 2003. First product to market more than 15 years ago, the original Roadster. Model S, slightly higher volume, 2012, first deliveries. 12 years ago, that thing wins every award ever and blows people's minds. Tesla's been all in on electric vehicles for longer than many people watching this video were born. Yet still, legacy automotive companies have not yet figured it out. Now, the reason I mention this is because 10, 15 plus years ago, Tesla's like, all right, electric vehicles, here's our plan. Let's dominate, execute, done. They literally told the master plan and they've been executing on that. That's literally last decade's news. Now Tesla is investing tens of billions of dollars in AI and autonomy and humanoid robots. And many short-sighted investors and all money managers are just focused on the automotive business. Tesla gross automotive margins. You can't pick stupid. I saw a great thread on X from Alex. Tesla's biggest so-called competitor, and I mean actually in terms of vehicles sold, neck and neck in terms of electric vehicle sales. Well, not quite neck and neck. Tesla's still ahead, but hey, BYD. Now, as far as I'm aware, BYD does not have their own Dojo chip, nor their own AI training supercluster. Tesla's still kicking their ass in terms of electric vehicles. Even in China, best-selling vehicle was not a BYD last year. It's a Tesla Model Y, a 2 to 3 times the average selling price of a BYD vehicle. Crazy. Tesla's AI efforts ultimately, in terms of the revenue and profits they're going to bring in, are going to dwarf the entire automotive business by multiple orders of magnitude. And that's not hyperbole, that is a statement of fact. Check back in 10, 20 years and let's see how my arrogance has played out. So maybe we'll take a look at BYD and see how the company is performing, given that they are Tesla's biggest competitor in terms of units sold, revenue. No one else is close. You got Tesla number one, especially in terms of profitability. Number two, BYD, and then it's tumbleweeds after that. But BYD aren't aggressively pursuing autonomy or humanoid robots. So let's see what their business looks like without the burden of investing extremely aggressively in solving autonomy and developing humanoid robots. We'll do the Cliff Notes version here. First of all, BYD's revenue increased 26% year over year. Total quarterly revenue, $24.3 billion. Not bad. Annualized, that's about $100 billion. Neck and neck with Tesla. And if you guys want to pause the video and be a total nerd, feel free. Number two, BYD's gross profit increased 26% year over year. So check that out. Revenue increased 26%, so too gross profit. That's good, although it'd be better if gross profit was increasing even faster due to economies of scale. But hey, tough times for the automotive industry. However, selling expenses are near all-time record highs. So overall, the trend for gross profit from BYD moving in a positive direction, very lumpy, very seasonal, as you can see. The December quarter in 2022 and 23, significantly above any previous quarter. However, year over year, selling expenses continue to climb quite substantially. Of course, if your revenue is growing, your sales are growing, you're going to expect that your selling expenses will also grow, but you want to become more efficient, so they're not growing in line with one another. And now here's where things get quite interesting. Administrative expenses reached an all-time high, but R&D expense decreased to the lowest level in four quarters. Meanwhile, I believe Tesla's spending about $10 billion this year in AI-related investments. It's not exactly apples to apples, but is this perhaps a sign that BYD is now kicking their feet up, turning on cruise control and just aiming to coast as opposed to aggressively innovate, drive costs down, develop new products? Just asking the question. Interestingly, we're seeing a rather troubling trend in terms of selling expenses. Ideally, you want to see this number coming down over time as you reach scale. But in the case of BYD, the selling expenses, 3%, 3.3, 4, 4.4, 5.4 a peak, and now slightly lower at 4.3. Again, basically just selling vehicles and some batteries. They also had a huge peak in terms of their administrative expenses at a 3% margin in the prior quarter, but now down to 2.2. So it appears BYD aggressively cutting costs and expenses. But is this a short-term strategy? Was it necessary? Or are they just trying to run an efficient business? Well, here's where things get interesting. The second quarter saw the first reduction in relative R&D spending in several years, demonstrating heightened cost concerns. BYD's cost-cutting efforts are reflected in the numbers, but may also contribute to BYD's slowing volume growth. So check this out. R&D expense margin climbing 3.5%, 3.7%, 5%, 5.4%, 6.8%, 8.1%, 8.5% in the prior quarter and then collapsing to 5.1%. A comparable trend with operating expense margin peaking at 17% in the previous quarter, now 11.6%. So clearly BYD's costs were getting out of control and they've made some major changes. But is this out of desperation and necessity or just good business management? The question would be then, how the fuck did they get so high in the first place? Operating profit increased 42% year over year to $1.3 billion for the quarter. Not bad. Interestingly, however, as I record this, roughly one quarter of BYD's profits currently come from government subsidies. This is one of the reasons we're hearing about extremely aggressive import tariffs on Chinese-made electric vehicles, many countries trying to compensate government subsidization. This slide also painting a rather interesting picture. BYD substantially reduced investments. AJ goes on to say that this may imply reduced growth expectations and heightened attention to cash conservation. So BYD's investments, as in capital expenditures, you know, the kind of shit, for example, that Tesla would be spending building AI training superclusters, etc., down 28% year over year. And we can see a huge, huge drop. Third quarter of 2023, almost $5 billion. Final quarter of the year, 2.9. And this year, significantly down. So is this a company that appears to be aggressively investing in scale and growth or slamming on the brakes? Another telling slide. Recent increases in cash burn wiped out all the cash BYD generated over the past 12 months for a net loss of $200 million. So BYD's trailing 12-month cash flow currently negative $0.2 billion. Yikes. This slide, rather concerning, at least if you're BYD. BYD's cash balance decreased 39% quarter over quarter to just $7.3 billion, which is the lowest level in six quarters. Now, for contrast, Tesla has over $30 billion of cash and cash equivalents. But let's just do a fun experiment. Anyone notice a trend in the last three quarters here? 15.1, 12.1, 7.3. Holy fuck. Now that we get to this slide, with everything that we've seen previously in mind, hey, look, I don't want to be causing too much concern here, but BYD might be in a bit of trouble. But the thing that really sticks out here, a 39% decrease in their cash balance. And remember, trailing 12 months, lost $200 million. So let's whip out the calculator. If BYD were to see another 39% quarter over quarter decrease in their cash, this 7.3, next quarter, 4.45. The following quarter, 2.71 billion. You can see where this is going. The following quarter, 1.65 billion. Then 1 billion. Now, to put this in context, okay, BYD annualized revenue in total roughly $100 billion. So at that point, their cash balance a year from now, if it continued to decline at that same rate of around $1 billion, would would be equivalent to about 1% of the annual revenue. So riddle me this. What if of that revenue, for whatever reason, they're making 1% less profit margin on that $100 million. Suddenly, they got $1 billion of cash and they're not adding it all to that pile, although keep in mind they're already losing. So I don't know how to say this other than holy fuck, dude. Meanwhile, Tesla's cash balance remains quite stable. So I'm just going to say this one more time. A year from now, four quarters from today, if, and I'm not saying it will, but if this trend continued, a 39% quarter over quarter decrease in cash balance from BYD, they'd have $1 billion left. I mean, that's chicken feed when you're a company this size. I mean, that's like, it's already red alert territory right now. It seems to me that BYD are in panic mode, as they should be, aggressively trying to cut costs. And this is actually going to stifle their ability to grow and scale and drive costs down and innovate and introduce new products. Remember, BYD, with paper-thin profit margins on its low-priced budget electric vehicles, they don't have a lot of wiggle room. I'm not saying they're going bankrupt tomorrow, but holy shit, they are in trouble. Tough times in the automotive industry. And unlike Tesla, BYD does not have fingers in the autonomy and or human robotics pies. Uh-oh. This chart is rather telling. Total battery electric vehicle deliveries for BYD monthly over the last couple of years. Impressive trend toward the end of 2023, right? In January, admittedly an abnormally low month, given the seasonality, 71,000. And then climbed the entire year to 191,000. And this is the point everyone's like, BYD is overtaking Tesla. Tesla loses the throne, loses the mantle, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, guys, don't get too far ahead of yourself. Next minute, January, 105,000, then 55. And now the trend no longer up. See, this is disturbing. And again, it's very tough times for the automotive industry. So I actually understand why. But a lot of investors, I think, had expectations that BYD would be selling 200,000 plus vehicles per month, electric vehicles per month throughout 2024. And it looks like they're going to be lucky to hit around 140, 150 on average. Let's see AJ's final thoughts. Bottom line, number one, BYD's significant cash burn for the second consecutive quarter is a major concern. BYD will likely slash production in the third quarter to release inventory capital, alleviating cash burn. It is likely that BYD's growth will significantly slow in the second half of 2024. And BYD's recent refocusing on fake electric vehicles suggests challenges in BYD's electric vehicle business. By the way, AJ, please do continue to share these long form analyses. So this is not a good sign for BYD. And while BYD is panicking about their automotive business, you got Tesla presenting at the Hot Chips conference. We got Musk showing off the gigantic new AI training supercluster in Austin, Texas. And Autonomy Day is just around the corner. Nothing to see here. Move along. Want more content? Early access? Bunch of perks, click the links in the pinned comment. AG1 is awesome. I've been taking it daily now for more than 3 years. It's a great way to fill in nutritional gaps. It's packed full of vitamins, minerals, and whole food source nutrients, plus has prebiotics, probiotics, and adaptogens to improve gut health, regularity, and help your body handle stress. I'm always looking for an edge to help me feel and perform my best, which is why I haven't missed a day of AG1 for more than 3 years. And I haven't missed a daily video in more than 3 years. Must be a coincidence, right? Just try it and see how you feel. Click the link in the pinned comment or head to drinkag1.com/smr and get yourself a free 1 year supply of vitamin D3 plus K2 and 5 travel packs. But don't take my word for it. This is what viewers of the channel had to say after trying AG1. I feel like I have a lot more energy since I started on AG1. By the way, viewer, that makes two of us. On to the next. Just got my AG1 in the mail. Legit feeling the effects after day three. This viewer's been taking AG1 for 8 months and says, what an investment. Another. 3 months ago, I started AG1 and have been enjoying the evenness of alertness and energy that lasts the day. I just started the wife on it too. Are you convinced yet? I mean, hey, it's worth trying, right? Click the link in the pinned comment or head to drinkag1.com/smr or I can keep going. Plenty more to come. This viewer, after about a month on AG1, definitely a lack of fatigue in the afternoon. Pleasant side effect is that my coffee intake has imploded and is almost down to zero. One more? Yeah, why not? I honestly feel younger and will be continuing to use AG1. This stuff really is crazy good. I didn't think it would be, but this stuff is awesome. It really is what everyone is saying. One more, don't mind if I do. I've just received my third month supply. I've drank it every day. I have so much energy throughout most of the day. I'm productive, started a new business, started socializing, refurbished a boat. It's no coincidence. Thank you for your persistence, your integrity, and your insights. Now look, These are not my words. These are not my testimonials. This is what you guys and girls are saying. Maybe it's 100% placebo effect. But even if that's the case, I think it's money well spent. Click the link in the pinned comment or head to drinkag1.com/smr and get yourself a free 1-year supply of vitamin D3 plus K2 and 5 travel packs. If you're still skeptical, hey, I don't blame you. Everyone on the planet seems to be promoting AG1 now, but guess what? They weren't nearly 3 years ago when I had this to say privately to my Patreon audience before there was a relationship, when I was asked about what I was doing for my health, energy, and so on. Just sharing my genuine, honest thoughts about a product I'd recently discovered that was at the time called Athletic Greens, now AG1.
If I could only recommend one supplement to take, Athletic Greens, and I'm not getting paid to say this, Athletic Greens is a fucking game changer. I cannot believe how effective this is. No longer having a lack of energy in the afternoons, it's fucking amazing. There's only one thing to recommend, seriously, try Athletic Greens, you won't go back.
So obviously, just like Elon Musk is a liar, a fraud, a con man, a scammer, a fake engineer, and Tesla's going bankrupt, you shouldn't trust that guy from about 3 years ago who, without any financial incentive, was promoting this product to his audience on Patreon when they were asking about health and what he's doing for supplements. Because obviously, there was some other reason he recommended that, obviously. Not sure what it was, but don't trust that guy. And all the testimonials, like my mental game has improved with AG1. I feel better than ever. I'm so impressed I've bought it for both my parents. I feel more focused and have better digestion. Incredible difference. No more afternoon fatigue. It's relieved gut issues. These are all just obviously fake testimonials from fake people. Right? Wrong. Just try it. Unless you hate yourself. If you hate yourself and you don't even want to risk possibly feeling better, this is not for you. But for everyone else, what's the worst that could happen? Try it for a month. See how you feel. It's a no-brainer. Just click the link in the pinned comment or head to drinkag1.com/smr. You'll get a free 1-year supply of vitamin D3 and K2 plus 5 travel packs. And you'll take the colossal risk that maybe you might have a similar experience to some of the people whose testimonials we've read in this video.